So now we move into the stomach.
Let's look at just characteristics of the stomach to begin with. So the empty volume of your stomach is about 50 milliliters. The full volume is about 1,000 milliliters, which is the same as saying 1 liter. The stomach secretes gastric juice, and we're going to be talking about what that gastric juice is here in just a little bit. And you have contractile smooth muscle that lines the wall of your stomach. What that does is it helps pulverize or break down your food particles and then mixes it with the juice to form a mixture called chyme. So it no longer completely resembles food that you actually ingested. So let's take a look into the components of the stomach. So there's the fundus of the stomach. So that's this upper part of your stomach here. And it has a thin wall that easily expands, and it contains gastric pits. Below the fundus is the body of the stomach. It has a gastric mucosa, and it folds into what are called rugae. What I want you to do is to figure out what is the function of the rugae. The antrum is the thickest portion of the stomach. When it contracts, it propels the chyme into the small intestine. We're going to refer to this as gastric emptying. Now there's one more section to the stomach that I've not listed here for you, and that's the pylorus. And so that's the last region of the stomach that the food will have to pass through before passing into the small intestine. So let's zoom in on these gastric pits for just a moment. The gastric pits contain secretory cells. Secretory cells, based on the name, you could guess they're going to secrete something. So the gastric pits then go down into the wall of the stomach. And there are lots of different types of cells that are associated with the gastric pit. So we have the mucous neck cells in blue. And what the neck cells do is they secrete mucus, which may help protect the lining of the stomach. Then we have the gastric glands, and they contain a couple or a few different, well, three different cell types at least. The chief cells secrete pepsinogen. So pepsinogen is a pepsin precursor. Pepsin is an enzyme, and this enzyme is a protease enzyme that breaks down protein. Parietal cells are going to secrete hydrochloric acid, and also something called intrinsic factor. Intrinsic factor is really important in the absorption of vitamin B12, and we'll come back to that later. The G cells secrete a hormone called gastrin. So again, gastrin is a hormone, very important in the regulation of the gastrointestinal system. Now, one thing we want to focus on is why is the lumen acidic? Well, the lumen has to be acidic in order to convert pepsinogen. Remember that this is our pepsin precursor, over to pepsin. If the lumen is not acidic, pepsinogen will not be converted to pepsin, and therefore pepsin will not be active, and you will not be able to break down protein. So that's one reason why the lumen is acidic. The second reason why the lumen is acidic is because it's going to kill any foodborne bacteria that you have ingested. So if there was bacteria on the food that you ingested, the bacteria gets down into the stomach, and the acidic environment kills it.